Hey folks, it's Hrithgar here. How you doing? I'm just down here and I'm going to collect these pallets of wool. Now, I think I've sort of dealt with some of the lag that I was experiencing with this map. Getting rid of the bales has helped. And I've also got rid of the two pallets that I bought for the Crone Ultima Baler. That's kind of helped as well. Now, the question for this week, which tractor do you want me to get? I need a bigger tractor than we've got because we've got about 250 horsepower on our Lamborghini, and I'm hiring a Deutz which is 260-ish, but that's not strong enough. So we need something a bit bigger. So that one there is 500 horsepower. That is the Fendt 1050. We have the Deutz FAR 7250 TTV Warrior, which looks pretty cool, I think. That's 320 horsepower. Or we have the John Deere 8370R, which is 370 horsepower. Head down below, let me know which one you want. It's your vote, it's your game. Now, I have got a huge amount of stuff that I need to do, and I don't really want to do very much of it today. The other thing that I have noticed with the lag is when I'm looking towards the middle of the map, I seem to get more lag than when I'm looking away from the middle of the map. So I'm not really sure what's going on there. Anyway, let me start this one up. And there's quite a few things that I need to get done. So let me just load up these wool pallets because we're going to take these up to the spinnery, or up to the shop, whichever one it is. And nope, I don't want that one. I want that one. The beef and the pigs. We've got several here ready to take to market, but we are almost out of grain. We're almost out of earth fruits. Silage is all right. We've got no water, no straw. So, and we've also got quite a bit of manure and slurry accumulating again. So we've got a lot of work to do. We've got to carry a load of stuff up for those. We've got not that much in the way of grass for both the sheep and the pigs. So we've got to take that in for them. And I'm not going to do any of that today. Not one little bit of it. Because what I want to do today, I want to start on the silage. I bought that field opposite the BGA plant, and I want to start making silage up there. So that is what I'm going to do. I'm going to buy a new header for our forager that we've got, that little old Rostelmash Don 680, is it? I can't remember the exact number of it, but we'll have a look in a minute. So as soon as I get this one up to the shop and we can sell these pallets, I've then got to get that forager up to the shop so that we can buy the new header for it. And that's quite wide, so we're going to have a bit of fun trying to get that along the roads down to the field that we're going to be cutting. Right, I brought these up. I thought I sold those two pallets. I will sell them now a minute, and we can buy them back another time when we think that we need them. I have to go to the garage to do this. There, right, so I want to sell that one. Yes, sold, and I want to sell that one. Yes, sell. Right, those two are now gone, so hopefully that will improve the lag just a little bit. I don't know if that's affecting it or not. If any of you have had issues with this Crone Baler causing lag, let me know. I would be interested to find out if that is what is causing it all. Now, which side was I was unloading on that side? So if I just nudge this one over here like this, look, and we'll come out of cab so that we can see this. I can't remember how much we get for each pallet. I don't think it's too bad though, is it? So unload them there. £4,800 per pallet. So we now have 125,000, which is not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. Now, I want to park up this trailer. If I back it, actually, let's do this from in cab. Let's see if we can do this from in cab. Turn around like that. I'm going to put it up against the wall over there so he's off out the way. And then I want to get the new header for our forager. Right, I'm going to leave that one there. The other issue that we've got is, let me just unhitch that a second. There we go. Right, rent time. I can extend rent time for $88, and I've got rent time is 2 hours left. I'm thinking that I would like to have this tractor actually. We did finish field 42, not 42, field 22. That has now been sown. Field 5 has been sown. We don't actually need to use this tractor, I don't think. We could unhitch the drill for a minute, and we could use the Lamborghini for doing that. So that means that we don't have to spend out on extending the rent time on this tractor. So I think actually, because we rented the front weight and the tractor, So we could just leave these here, and the rent time will expire on them, and that will be the end of it. So we don't actually need to worry about it. Bit of bad driving there. Right. So I'm going to leave that one there. That one, we'll come back to it another time. Now, I'll just get rid of that. Right, so I'm going to get back down and get our Don Forager that we've got, and we need to unhitch that header and then bring it up here. Right, I'm back at the yard, and it's always here in the yard that lag is at its worst. And I'm wondering if this is anything to do with it. We've got our manure heap here, but it doesn't actually have manure on it. We've just got that sort of shadow over it, so we've sort of got invisible manure. And I am wondering if that is anything to do with it. But I know that our lag is at its worst whenever we're in here. I suppose it might actually be the straw power plant out there. I really don't know. Right, anyway, enough about that. Let's get this one started up. This is a noisy old beast, this one. Right, the Don 680 is what it is. And I'm going to turn it round and then unhitch the header, leave that one here in the yard. And then we've got to drive this one back up. Let's go in cab. There we go. And I'll put this header over here. And we'll unhitch it here. And then we can drive this one up to the shop so that we can get the next header. Because we are going to use that one a bit, I think, this other header that I want to get. So, oh no, he's already lowered down. So put that one there. Unhitch. It does drop a little bit, which isn't ideal. I can just actually see the mirrors as well, which is good. So back up a little bit. Give that one a sec. I don't want to swing too sharp just yet. Right, now I'll come round and I'll get this one up to the shop. I've been using this one for a fair while now, and I was saying to you before, I didn't know what that steering thing was. We've got an option there for steering. Your M to open the door. So I could do that a second. Yeah, see, that opens up that door. You can have that one open or closed. But steering, whatever was that? So, look, it puts the steering wheel up so you can actually use it. And it's not right up in the air up above you. That's brilliant. That's such an awesome little touch, and I had no idea it was here. So, yeah, I'm quite pleased with that. Right, anyway, onwards and upwards. I'm not sure these poor folks are going to want something like this roaring down past them on a regular basis. I think I'd be having a few words of complaint about something like that. But anyway, it's not my house. I don't need to worry about it. What I do need to worry about is this one. We want to go to headers, and we want to go over to here. This one here is a 5-meter hole crop. It does grass, wheat or barley, and does it as a whole crop. It cuts it direct and whooshes it straight into the machine. So let's get that so we can do some whooshing. We now have £113,000. I'm thinking I might buy some more cows. Not quite sure when we'll buy more cows, because I want to get grass. We're going to concentrate on this harvest first. We got all that money, so we might actually, once we get a little bit more, now that we're going to get silage, we're going to get a few other bits and pieces as well. We've got a load of eggs that we can sell. There's a few other things that I want to try as well. But, yeah, so what was my point? I had a point before I started rattling again. How am I going to get this out of here? Seriously. This, it doesn't really fit. I'm not going to be able to get this up the road. And I don't have, I'm going to need a transport trailer to carry this on, aren't I? Right, okay. This it's just not going to fit if I carry it like that. And I can't really cut across fields. I had a point. I'm sure I had a point somewhere. I was going to say, we might have enough money to buy our combine soon. Let's just quickly check. That's what I was actually getting to. Our Classlexian 580 is the one that we were going to get. It's that one. 270,000. It might be a little while before we can afford that one. Let's just take a look. What options have we got? We could hire the low loader and a... Yeah, if we hire the low loader, we could put the header onto that one. I don't think we're going to be able to put this header onto one of these header trailers. I might actually be able to get it onto the Homer header trailer. That one might fit. Or the Crone Cutter. Because the Crone Cutter... You know, I'm going to risk it. I'm going to buy the Crone Cutter, and we'll see if it fits. Because if it does, that's going to be perfect. We can use this one to carry this monstrous great big header down. So let me bring it over here. It's raised up in the air at the moment. Now, I know that it's not meant for this one, but I'm hoping that that will fit. It does look like it will fit. Let's unhitch. Right, that's not ideal. That's really not ideal. Right, that sort of slid down a bit, and I don't think it's going to lock in place in any way. There is no way to lock it on, though, is there? No. Right. Well, let's get this one loaded on and see. I'm confident that it is going to be okay, because we can at least tow it with this one. So let's back up a little bit. Back up, back up, back up. There we go. Right. Hopefully, it will work. It's holding it. I think we're going to be all right with this. It's not the one designed for it, and it does sort of, it has slid around a bit, but I think it's going to work. I think we're going to be okay. Right. I'm going to get this over to the field. If I run into any mishaps, I will show you. I'm just coming up to the BGA, and our field is right in here. I just come out of cab a second. I haven't had any issues whatsoever, actually. It's gone really well. I have not had any problems with this header or the trailer or anything else. So, yeah, I'm really pleased with that. Bring this one in over here. I'm not going to be too concerned about getting right in tight to the hedge with the cutting. And I'm just going to stop that one there. And then I'm going to go and get the Lamborghini tractor. Let me just stop that one a second. I'm going to go and get the Lamborghini and the trailer and bring those up over here as well. So then we can start on our silage. I was just about to wash this tractor, but it's just started raining. So we're in for a dull and dreary afternoon. But I don't think I need to worry about washing the tractor. So I'll get the trailer now, and I'll get back up to that field so that we can make a start on our silage. Because we can at least do that in the rain. It's not ideal, but we can do it in the rain. Right, I got the trailer down here, and I'll just leave the trailer right here in this gateway. And then I'm going to move over here with the tractor, because we're not actually going to tow it round the field to start with the tractor. We're just going to use the forager. And the reason is, I'm hoping we'll do a couple rounds with the forager, and then after we've done a couple rounds with the forager, we'll be able to get the hired help going. I don't know if hired help will actually do it like I'm hoping it will. And if it does, then we can just sort of follow up and down the field with the tractor and gather everything up. So let's just pick this one up. Hopefully I can pick it up off of here. I don't see why I won't be able to. Yep, perfect. Right. I'm really, really pleased with that trailer. I'm glad we bought that one. I know it's designed for the chrome whole crop header, but overall I think that is a pretty good machine. Now let's back up here. I wonder if I can do this in cab. I have tested this, and the animation on it is a little bit peculiar. Whoa. I haven't actually tested this before. Let me just come out and have a look at that. yeah. Okay. Hang on. I want to go here and then open that one. Yeah. Right, we'll just start right here. It's very, very low. Okay, we're going to do this little... actually, no. I'm going to come into cab. I'll ignore that for a minute. And switch that off. Right. Start it up. Lower it down. Ooh. Is it bouncing because of the trailer? I don't think so. Right. Yeah, it is bouncing a little bit because of the trailer, because of the angle that it's at. But overall, it's pretty good. The animation for grass is actually, it makes it look like canola going in there, but that's just a minor little detail, and it's not really anything I'm particularly concerned about. Incidentally, the lag issue It's better over this side of the map. It's still not great. I'm still below 20 frames a second, but I'm not down at 10 like I am back at the yard or along the road up the middle. This is episode 28, is it? 27 or 20? I honestly can't remember. It's somewhere around that. If I can't sort out this lag issue, I'd like to try and do the sugar beet harvest. We're doing some silage now. I'd like to try and do the sugar beet harvest. Then I'll sort of have touched on a lot of things that this map has got to offer. And if I can't really sort out this issue with the lag, I might stop playing this map sooner than I had originally intended. I had originally intended to run 40 to 50 episodes. And maybe even longer than that, depending on how it went. But this lag is sort of, for me, it's spoiling the enjoyment of the actual map, which is a bit of a shame. I'm gonna play around with mods. I'll try looking at a clean folder and see if there's anything in particular that it is doing. I will try all the usual tests and see if I can come up with anything that is causing it. But at present, I can't really see any conflicts because I don't have this issue on any other map that I've got. It's only on this one. I'm disappointed at that. I really am. There's got to be a conflict going somewhere, but I do know that this map was fairly heavy anyway. It's a little bit of a shame. So, yeah, I will try and do the sugar beet harvest. And, yeah, I'm getting quite a bit of lag on this now. I'm just getting, like, little spikes coming in here and there. So, I'll try and do that sugar beet harvest. We're doing some silage here, which we will see about selling here at the BGA. And, little bit more with the beef and the pigs. We've done that. We have had a look at it. We put stuff in there. But the only thing I haven't done, other than the sugar beet, is make some hay. So I would like to make some hay and try getting a bit of mixed rations in for the different animals. So we can get a feeder, what are they called? I can't remember what they're called now. You know the one that I mean. The mixed rations feeder. Mixer wagon. Yeah, have a look at getting a mixer wagon and seeing what I can do with that one. I will have covered a lot of different tasks on farm, and we will sort of experienced a bit of it. So I would feel okay then with moving on to a new map. I'm sorry if it would be... I'm quite disappointed myself. I realise it could be disappointing because we did have bigger plans. So some of the questions I asked you was I was going to go up to like 500 dairy cows on this farm, which is quite an undertaking. Possibly a little bit too ambitious, I think. 500, maybe 200 should have been the maximum I set. But anyway, so I'm going to have a look around at other maps. First of all, I will see what I can do about the lag issues, and like I said, I will check the mods folders and see if there's anything else I can do. I did attempt this game earlier on much lower settings, but quite frankly, I'm not happy with that. I'm used to a certain visual quality when I play, and lowering the settings to try and get rid of some of the lag did work. It did actually work. But the visual quality was so much poorer that I don't really want to do that. It's not something that I'm prepared to do. So I'm going to start looking around at some other maps. So you can always head down below and give me some suggestions. I realise that Thornton and Knavesville Farm are both very popular at the moment. And I know that I do think they are both quite good. Sandy Bay was another one that I was possibly considering. And I don't know what else. I know there's another one. Is it Senin Valley, the one that's just come out recently? Like in the last week or so? It might be Senin Valley. I might be thinking of something else entirely. There are a few different ones that are out there, and I would like to cover a few different ones. So if you've got some suggestions of maps that you'd like me to have a look at, if we can't sort of sort out this lag issue that we got with this one, let me know as well. I'm always open to suggestions. And I'll start having a look through and see what we can do about it all. Right, how are we doing with this trade? We got 66% at the moment. I'm going to come out of cab a second. Ooh, that's cool. And it is filling up quite nicely. And this header is doing a good job. It's a little bit slow, admittedly. But not too bad overall, I would say. I think it's going to take a little while to complete. But you've got to remember that this is a very, very old forager. And I think for my next map, or at least for my next modern days map, I'm excluding the old times one that I'm playing at the moment, because obviously that is completely different. I'm going to go for a slightly newer forager, because this one is good and all, but it's extremely noisy and it is still slow compared to the newer ones. So I think hiring machines until we can afford them is the way to go from now on, or at least for something like this, same as we're doing with the combine. So rather than, because I was considering buying an old combine and then working our way up, so I might do that with the combine in the next episode, in the next map, and then hire and keep a brand new, really shiny, awesome forager. So sort of swap between the two. Not really sure yet. Right, so we're up to 80%, and we're almost out of time, actually. So I'm just going to fill this one up completely, and then we can tip it before I go. Right, about two, 1.5 times around the field is one trader full. So we will grab this one now and we will tip it. And then before the next episode, I'm going to do another trailer full. So I'll have done three times. Actually, I'm gonna do four times around the field. So I'll have done four times around the field, and then we can start using hired help. I'm hoping to move up and down the field. Now, the only issue is if we get a sudden growth stage on the grass and it moves up one, in which case he may then decide to start going right out to the edge of the field and back. Not really sure what's going to happen with that, so we'll sort of watch this space. We'll see what happens in our next episode. And it's all gone laggy again. It only seems to be when I'm looking towards the middle of the map. It doesn't matter where I am, but if I'm looking towards the centre, it goes really laggy. I actually am wondering if it's the straw power plant. Because I don't recall it being this bad prior to putting that straw power plant there. Although I don't actually remember it doing it with the straw power plant to start with. We'll see. That's something that I need to have a look at. But I'm going to get round the edge of the field and then get this down to the BGA just at the bottom there.